Check. Does it matter if we leave our binders open or
closed? Can I let them say a few words? Okay, why don't you guys pick a paragraph, just so that, so with this kind of setup, everything's going that way. I think they have a little speaker that you might hear a little bit, but go ahead and pick a paragraph, take your mask off, and just start.
I'll just do my opening paragraph.
Yeah,
I'm gonna do mine as well.
Good morning, everyone. It is really, really good to see all of you. Families and friends, teachers and administrators, and of course, my classmates. I have missed you. I'll admit that there was a long period of time when I didn't think we would be able to be here at all. So I believe I speak for the entire class when I say thank you to the Greenhill faculty and staff for the incredible.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Lee Hark, head of school at Green Hill School. Welcome to Green Hill's 70th commencement ceremony and the commencement for the class of 2020. It's my pleasure to welcome you all here this morning. I'm sure you understand the meaning behind my saying thanks for coming. Thanks, too, for working within a structure and set of rules for this ceremony that were necessary to help keep us safe and allowed us to hold this ceremony at all. These days, it's a team effort applies to just about everything. And I want to thank, before continuing, Rebecca Schumann and Jack Oros, Trevor Worcester, and April Burns, and our senior advisors for making the impossible happen. Parents and friends, this has been one of the most extraordinary, interesting, and challenging years in Green Hill's history. I say that knowing full well that a potentially extraordinary, interesting, and challenging year is right around the corner. But today we bring closure to an important chapter in the lives of these graduates, closure that I know we all know is long overdue. Thank you for the support you have given to these young men and women, your children, our students, this amazing, incredible class of 2020. Enough from me for now. I know it's warm. This is not a time for bloviating. I will bloviate later with the students when we're all good and sweaty. Just a reminder, please silence your cell phones. Enjoy the ceremony.
Bach Advisory. Mike Bach has just finished his second year teaching math and computer science. Today, Michael Legacy is standing in for Mr. Bach. Mr. Legacy just completed his 20th year at Green Hill, and I want to give him my heartfelt thanks and gratitude for his years of service and wish him health and happiness in retirement.
Musa Ijaz Aziz. Luke Emmanuel Contreras. Lola Isabel Frankel. Kylie Carson Hashimoto. Kieran Elizabeth Jayasilan. Michelle Pearl Leung. Jonavi Kaimel Nair. Carter Vale Truitt. Ilan Maxwell Wider. The Cotton Advisory. Scott Cotton teaches in the History Department, coaches our boys' varsity tennis team, teaches with Global Online Academy, and is a former department chair. Natalie Gonchar. Jeffrey Marks Harburg. Atiria Umashankar Iyer. Siddharth Venkat Kalasetti. Michael Lynn Magruder, Jr. Michael Hayden Rayburn. Jordan Elizabeth Thompson. Samantha Mila Ungerman. Melinda Lee Shu. Valerie House Smith Advisory. Valerie House Smith is our theater director who brought us Romeo and Juliet and the musical Carrie this past year. She is graduating her first advisory. Sophie Hope Barron. Isabel Grace Clint. Victoria Garcia. Hayden Seth Jacobs. Evan Alexander McNeil, in absentia. Bruno Alexander Pasquinelli, in absentia. Arjun Sharawath Lal. Anna Riley Rabinowitz. Eden Julia Schachter. Caleb Jackson Smith. Nicole Victoria Stahoviak, in absentia. Vinay Kupachi Bas. The Colvin Advisory. Dr. Trey Colvin, who teaches English, is completing his 19th year at Greenhill, and this is his fifth advisory to graduate. Will Barron. Catherine Grace Brodsky. Riley William Cook. Sri Veda Dulipala. Varun Gande. Rebecca Ann Hain, in absentia. Anand Kishore Jan. Lillian Schuyler McClendon. Jacob Carl Middleman. Lisbeth Ortiz Prieto, in absentia. Helena Shan. The Warner Advisory. Steve Warner, who achieved Greenhill Legend status last year for serving 25 years at Greenhill, teaches in the math department and is our upper school scheduler. Preston John Bulbin. Dejana Andronique Cook. Samuel Brown Donnelly. Angelo John Drosis. Divya Inaganti. Emma Francis Kaiser. Gabrielle Morgan Malazzi. Veda Velamuri. Brooke Lynn Webster. Samson Wayman Williford. Keyonce Jalea Woods. Right here. Anais Charlotte Jung. The Burns Woodson Advisory. Miss Angela Woodson is escorting the advisory today. As our Director of Community Service and Service Learning, Ms. Woodson has been instrumental in providing students online options to serve our community during this pandemic. William Harrison Coben. Ashton Bud Collins IV. Alexa Maya J. Derryberry. Jordan Scott Gashman. In absentia. Sarah Hirani. Morgan Elizabeth Hurst. Isha Chulka. Jonah Cameron Lee. John Francis Nickel McDonald, in absentia. Ethan Alexander Newman. Timothy Lawrence Owens II, in absentia. Nikhil Venkat Ratnam. Iman Reza Siadati. Amber Aisha Syed. The Hayes Thomas Advisory. Ms. Sonia Hayes is our upper school librarian, co-coordinator for equity and inclusion for the upper school, and assistant coach for our cheerleading squads. Dr. Karen Thomas teaches 10th grade English and great upper electives such as creative writing, global literatures, and race and subjectivity in literature. Chirag Girish Bachani. Jordan Scott Gashman, not in absentia. Sophia Rose Hurst. Alexandria Raquel King. Joseph Vincent Mallory, in absentia. Emma Tu Merriman. Caitlin Manuela Ness. Rhea Amul Rundle. Malcolm Xavier Taylor. Benjamin Turk Samuel Yeager. The Eyed Advisory. Barry Eyed teaches biology in our science department, and he just completed his 21st year at Greenhill. Mr. Jacobo Luna is escorting the Eyed Advisory today. Mr. Luna teaches upper school Spanish and is a current advisor to the class of 2022. Ethan Stephen Brockett. Emily Elise Kaplan. Mohan Hemang Desai. Ronick Aaron Dingra. Eamon Michael Guinan, in absentia. Ayaka Hoshida. Connor Wensu Liang. Lindsay Gray Maxwell. Olushala Omolara Oluwakemi Omonaje. Julia Stolman Townsend. Cade Douglas Wetherill, in absentia. The Garza Advisory. Joel Garza is the Upper School English Department Chair, teaches ninth grade English, upper electives such as modern fiction and nature and uses of language, teaches with Global Online Academy, and this is his fourth advisory to graduate. April Burns is escorting the Garza advisory today. In addition to seeing her own advisory graduate, April assumed the role of 12th grade level dean this year, and she teaches Spanish in the upper school. Her collaboration in this ceremony has been extremely helpful, and I am grateful for all the work she has done. Griffin Smith Benners. Catherine R. Franklin, in absentia. Sana Sashi Jaleel. Serenio Brian Lopez. Colin Anthony McDade. Mark Anthony Malgarejo. Drake Anthony Muller. Natalie Ji Young Park. Hannah Renee Reynolds. Caroline Marie Sasso. Matthew Jonathan Varnick. Paige Hendren Wheeler. The Kiang Advisory. Miss Grace Kiang is our learning specialist for 11th and 12th grades. Before moving into the upper school, she taught Chinese in the middle school, and this is her first upper school advisory to graduate. John Frederick Olson Berry. Grant Alexander Bulmosh. Ellie Clarita Desopolis. Maddie Ann Hatfield. Mason Vin Hua. Joshua Stein Leffler. Haley Nicole Lieberman. Adam Amirali Medhi. Natalie Ann Neiman. Sonali Natani. Kaifa Marie Thomas. Alex Reed Withheiler. Graduates, please stand. Green Hill community, families, and friends, I present to you the class of 2020. You may be seated. As commencement is a celebration of the senior class, it is only fitting that we will be hearing addresses from two members of the class of 2020. More than anyone else, it is our seniors who embody the best in who we are as a school, and it is an honor to be hearing from representatives of the class of 2020 this morning. It is now my pleasure to introduce our first student speaker, Josh Leffler.
Good morning, everyone. It is really, really good to see all of you. Families and friends, teachers and administrators, and of course, my classmates. I have missed you. I'll admit that there was a long period of time when I didn't think we would be able to be here at all. So I believe I speak for the entire class when I say thank you to the Green Hill faculty and staff for the incredible amount of time and energy you've poured into making today possible. Six years ago, when I was new to Green Hill, I spent a great deal of time thinking about what my life would be like by my senior year. I was feeling apprehensive about the prospect of joining a new school in a new city, having just moved halfway across the country, and not knowing anyone in my new surroundings. I was scared that I wouldn't find my people, that I wouldn't be happy in my new home. As much time as I spent considering all of the different possibilities for what my time at Green Hill would be like, if you had told me that this is what my last year in high school would look like, I most certainly would not have believed you. A highly contagious virus effectively shutting down the entire world for months and months. Finishing my final high school classes online while sitting in my bedroom. And all of the other things that have made these past few months so challenging. More than any of that, though, if you had told me 6 years ago that the hardest part of this whole situation would be how much I would miss all of the friends I'd made over the previous 6 years, and how hard it would be to say goodbye to them without the final few weeks we expected to have together, I really would not have believed you. Over the past few months, though, as I've given it more thought, which, as you might imagine, I've had plenty of time to do, and as it's been longer and longer since we were all back together in school, I realized that it's not just being separated from my closest friends or the loss of such big events as prom and an in-person baccalaureate that's been so difficult. Rather, I've missed sitting in the dining hall, relishing the joy of sharing lunch with my classmates. I've missed contentedly standing in the checkout line at the Buzz. I've missed the comfort of walking across campus to the science building with whoever else happened to be making the same walk at the same time. Quite simply, I've missed the day-to-day experience of being with you as a class.
As a class, we are full of differences and diversity that enrich our community. Sure, in terms of background and experiences, but also in terms of our passions and interests, in terms of who we are as students. I am constantly amazed by the members of our class who are experts on the environment, and the others who have mastery of poetry and literature. We have people who are tremendously accomplished in their studies of math, and others who are incredibly talented athletes. There are those of us who have invested immense amounts of time in political causes, and others who have dedicated just as much time to complex theater productions. There are, of course, many more examples, but beyond that, we are also diverse in how we connect with each other. There are those among us who love to be vocal and who jump in at every opportunity to loudly share their thoughts. And there are those among us who tend to hold back and be quieter. But when they do speak up, what they say is incredibly insightful and powerful. The result is that we challenge each other intellectually and emotionally. But at the same time, we love each other. And more than anything else, that is what makes the class of 2020 so unique. We don't let all of our differences fragment us into social groups that are based entirely on a particular activity or interest. Instead, we have actively formed really meaningful, treasured friendships across all of our many perspectives. My favorite manifestation of this, the mental image that I will cherish for years to come, is the senior pod, where many of us spent our breaks and free periods back when we were all on campus. Each and every day, when I walked into the senior pod, I saw different groups of two or three people, people who, based on their activities and interests, you wouldn't necessarily expect to be friends, engrossed in a deep discussion about complex and important issues, or enjoying a lighter conversation about what they were watching on Netflix or last night's Mavs game. The result is that we as a class have created a really concrete sense of camaraderie, of we're all in this together. Throughout high school, and most recently throughout the great fun that is the college process, we as a class have done an exceptional job of celebrating each other's successes and helping each other through our challenges. We have grown to trust each other, to be there for each other, and to rely on each other. Whether it was reading one more college essay or getting through the infamous pig dissection in 10th grade, we have formed a family, and one that is very difficult to say goodbye to. After all, that community and sense of togetherness has defined each of our lives for anywhere from 2 to 14 years. We have not built that community by ourselves, though. Throughout each of our Green Hill experiences, our teachers and advisors have taught us the tools and given us the encouragement we needed to connect with each other and form a community. They have created spaces in their classes and in clubs for different groups of us to spend time together, and worked with each of us individually to grow as people and as community members. They have prepared us to make a difference in the world, and we will forever be grateful for the dedication and care that all of our teachers over the years put into making that happen. At the end of the day, though, we as a class were a final and crucial step in solidifying that community. All 111 of us, and the unbreakable bonds we have formed with people outside of our core friend groups and activities. Bonds that unite us today, even as we are 6 feet apart, and that will stay with us for years and years to come. In short, the class of 2020 is so special because of the students who compose it. That understanding does not make leaving any easier. But it does mean that, as we all head our own separate ways and join new communities all over the world, we each have the power to create that sense of camaraderie once again, thanks to those tools given to us by our mentors in the Green Hill faculty. We can build those relationships in our dorms and in our classrooms, in our sports teams and in our a cappella groups, and in every other place we go simply by doing what we have done here at Green Hill, making the effort to connect with people who are different from us, whether in background or in personality or in passions. And as we do that, we can strengthen the communities that we are all about to join and bridge some divides in a world that desperately needs a little more unity. Parents and other family members, thank you for your support and love as we have navigated this journey. Faculty and staff, you have shaped how we think and how we see the world. Thank you for always going above and beyond, and we will miss you all. And finally, the class of 2020. I have been incredibly lucky over the past 6 years to be surrounded by people who are as strong, diverse, and vibrant as you all are. I will miss you, my classmates, my friends, greatly next year. But I am so looking forward to hearing all about the communities you join and the differences you make over the next 4 years. Thank you.
The Helen Fulton Award is named in honor of founding faculty member and wife of Green Hills founder, Bernard Fulton. Helen Fulton was a lifelong learner, exemplary citizen, and a well-rounded, balanced individual. This award is special because seniors nominate their peers whom they believe embody these characteristics, and then the winners are chosen by a faculty vote. Students, when I call your name, please stand up and remain standing until all recipients have been named. You may pick up your award at the table near the Three Chimneys building as you are dismissed. The Helen Fulton Award recipients for 2020 are Griffin Benners, Mohan Desai, Varun Gande, Jeffrey Harburg, Ateria Iyer, Jack McDonald, Shula Omonaje, Caroline Sasso, and Amber Syed. Please join me in congratulating the class of 2020 Helen Fulton Award recipients. For each of the following awards, I would ask the recipient to stand when called for their recognition. Like those who received a Helen Fulton Award, the recipients for the following awards can pick them up outside the Three Chimneys building when you are dismissed from the ceremony. The salutatorian is the graduating senior who has achieved the second highest cumulative grade point average during the course of their upper school years at Green Hills School. A deep thinker and an expert problem solver. This is how one science teacher described this year's salutatorian. Exemplary in science and math, the student enrolled in 8 AP courses in junior and senior years, and 5 of those were in those two disciplines. Her BC calculus teacher noted that, quote, her insight and accuracy are remarkable. And after her stellar finish in that class during junior year, she went on to excel in our post-AP math course, vector calculus and differential equations this past year. Further, her work in our humanities courses was top-notch, as one of her English teachers indicated, quote, her written responses extend beyond what is required as she follows an idea and develops it further. Her mastery in the Chinese language, her skill to complete a portfolio for AP 3D art, and her ability to excel in all disciplines contributed to incredible achievement in the classroom and this deserving award. The salutatorian for the class of 2020 is Ateria Iyer. The valedictorian is the graduating senior who has achieved the highest cumulative grade point average during the course of their upper school years at Green Hills School. This year's valedictorian has excelled across the academic disciplines. Selected in 10th grade to take AP Biology, the student has enrolled and succeeded in 8 AP courses and 1 post-AP course across 5 different disciplines in upper school. Looking at his transcript, it's a sea of A's and A pluses, indicative of the highest achievement. His former English teacher noted, quote, because he understands the value of stepping out in front, he is aware that taking intellectual risks pays dividends. His contributions always elevate the work of everyone else. As a top-ranked debater, he has gained an inordinate amount of knowledge on a wide variety of topics and mastered skills that he has easily transferred into each of his classes. The valedictorian for the class of 2020 is Josh Leffler. The Estelle Dickens Service to Green Hill Award is presented to the senior who has given the most outstanding service contribution to Green Hill School. The award commemorates the over four decades of service given to Green Hill by beloved teacher and administrator Estelle Dickens. A monetary stipend from the Scott Buchanan Memorial Scholarship Fund accompanies the award. This year's recipient has effortlessly served the Green Hill community across a wide range of activities. Regardless of the club, competitive league, or artistic endeavor, this student exudes humility, grace, and brilliance. A friend once noted that she loves the things she does, and she loves the people around her. Whether she's performing for our dance company, competing in multiple local, state, and national Latin contests, contributing to the victories of Motorhead Robotics for 4 years, expressing her passion for anime for the SOS Brigade, or seeing her film be accepted into South by Southwest, she represents Green Hill so incredibly well. One faculty member noted, "She grows learning communities and inspires those around her. Those are gifts that cannot be taught." This year's Estelle Dickens Service to Green Hill Award is presented to Michelle Leung. Kate Cecil Award is given to the senior who renders the most outstanding service to the Dallas community. The award is named in honor of Kate Cecil, a member of the faculty for 17 years. A monetary stipend accompanies the award. This year's recipient has shared her gifts and time to myriad causes, both on and off campus. During 10th grade, she was one of 10 dedicated youth volunteers to be part of a nature-bound trip with the Dallas Zoo Youth Volunteer Program. But the majority of her time has been spent with the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. Since 9th grade, she has been a Discovery Corps volunteer, and because of her dedication and service to the museum, this past year, she was named a Discovery Corps lead volunteer and named as one of the outstanding volunteers of the year for the Perot Museum. In 2019 alone, she logged more than 350 hours there. The respect earned from her peers and faculty clearly transcends the walls of Green Hill to the greater community, and I suspect that will continue for her. This year's Kate Cecil Award is presented to Veda Velamuri. The Philip G. Foote Award is given to the senior who is considered by the faculty to epitomize the qualities of citizenship in the Green Hill community. These qualities are rooted in the school's core principles of honor, respect, and compassion. The award is named for Green Hill's second head of school. This year, we have two recipients for this award, and I will recognize each student separately. Positive energy, engaging demeanor, dedication to discovery, integrity. These are recurring themes and comments from every faculty member who had the pleasure of teaching our first recipient. Even more specific, one of his former English teachers wrote, quote, "He provides a true model for both scholarship and citizenship, and I know I am a better person for having worked with him." This aura and karma of goodwill happens in any encounter with this student. His college counselor remarks, quote, "Possessing a seemingly endless supply of warmth, smiles, and positive energy, he is unfailingly respectful and inclusive, doing everything in his power to make those in his shared space feel welcomed, heard, and valued. His ability and willingness to think outside of himself and to care about and for others, whether on campus or off, is the tonic for the toxicity of today's world." And amongst his peers, as one friend remarked, "He's one of the most genuine people I know." A needed tonic indeed. This year's first Philip G. Foote Award is presented to Adam Meddy. Our second recipient is consistently described as a thoughtful, genuine, intelligent, and respectful student. Regardless of the setting, this student is a positive influencer. In the classroom, he is described as a natural leader, one who has a unique ability to actively listen and engage with his peers in a civil way. In the studio, he works on his photography portfolio with drive and determination, and a steadying presence and powerful voice. On the court, he excels at his game as he consistently encourages his teammates. One of his peers wrote, quote, "He is a selfless person and is always there to help others when needed." He has built relationships across this community, mentoring our younger students, modeling our core principles of honor, respect, and compassion, and leaving a legacy to emulate. How fitting that he will address his class momentarily. This year's second Philip G. Foote Award is presented to Drake Muller. The Board of Trustees Award is given to the senior who has met the challenge of Green Hill School with perseverance, courage, and humor. This year's recipient has modeled those three qualities, perseverance, courage, and humor, like no other student in my time in education. Throughout the student's journey in upper school, challenges, obstacles, and life-changing events presented themselves to her, threatening to impact the goals she has had for years. And for most adults, those challenges would be insurmountable. But for this extraordinary young adult, she persevered with irreplaceable courage and lasting humor and warmth. One faculty member noted that despite experiencing such incredibly difficult circumstances, quote, "She has continued to put the school and her various causes first, doing everything in her power to make sure her commitment to them has remained high, her passion undiluted, and her work top-notch. She has gifted us with unforgettable and inspiring life lessons through her grace, kindness, dedication, selflessness, and resilience." Another faculty member remarks, "It is that she has persevered at a level almost unimaginable, with impeccable academic performance, significant commitment and leadership in the student community, and never failing grace and care for others, even while she has known pain and uncertainty." A remarkable young woman, poised to make a difference and share her gifts with her next community, this year's Board of Trustees Award is presented to Alexandria King. The Senior Leadership Award is given to the member of the senior class who best demonstrates the qualities of leadership. The origin of this award was the D. Harold Byrd and Jenny Stuck Awards, which honored male and female leadership. "She challenges me to be my best self." That is a quote from a peer of this year's recipient, and it demonstrates how this student engages in bettering our school across all sides of the Green Hill Triangle, academically, artistically, and athletically. In some instances, this student is elected to a leadership position, such as captaining or co-captaining multiple sports teams. In other instances, it is through mentoring or modeling, as many peers and faculty remark how her selflessness and willingness to put the team or group ahead of her own self-interest garner the respect and admiration a leader needs to be effective. Her efforts are rooted in the pursuit of community, humbly moving each class, each team, each group forward. One faculty member gave her this high praise. "I have to think that back in 1950, she would have boldly signed up to help Bernard Fulton launch a new and ambitious school committed to academic excellence and care for the well-being of those inside and outside the community. And if she had been one of those founding teachers, she would have been one of those who refused to take pay in their first year of service." President of the Honor Council, captain or co-captain of the cross-country, basketball, and track teams, and guided by impeccable integrity and a moral compass we need in the future, this year's Senior Leadership Award is presented to Katie Ness. And finally, the Bernard L. Fulton Award is the highest honor given in the upper school and is presented to the senior who best embodies the mission and ideals of Green Hill School. The award is named for the founder and first head of Green Hill School. This student embodies an exemplary humanitarian spirit and is selfless and intrinsically motivated to help improve the lives of those around him. That's how one faculty member characterized this year's recipient, and it's a fitting description for this student. Regardless of your encounters with this student, he puts your needs ahead of his own. Need help in a class? He's there for you. Want to strategize on how to make our core principles more present? He can do it. Need an ambassador for the community, on or off campus? He'll be there for you. The level of engagement and achievement he has modeled throughout his time at Green Hill transcends our expectations and is truly representative of our mission. And if you needed one more piece of evidence to demonstrate this embodiment of Green Hill, I'll remind you of what he said moments ago in his address to the class. Quote, "And as we make the effort to connect with people who are different from us, whether in background or in personality or in passions, we can strengthen the communities that we are all about to join and bridge some divides in a world that desperately needs a little more unity." Need someone to help bring unity to a community? This young man can do it. This year's Bernard L. Fulton Award is presented to Josh Leffler. It is now my pleasure to introduce Drake Muller, who will deliver the second of our senior addresses this afternoon.
Good morning, everyone. It's so great to be back and see everyone's happy and healthy faces today. Before I begin, I would like to thank Mr. Hark, Mr. Worcester, Mr. Oros, Mrs. Schumann, and the rest of the faculty for their leadership and perseverance that made today possible. The COVID-19 pandemic has drastically changed our world. It has forced us to alter many of our plans, but it has also presented us with opportunities to grow and reflect under these unique circumstances. I have grown from the advice given to me by an NBA legend. During my seemingly endless time at home social distancing, I had the privilege of listening to former Dallas Maverick Dirk Nowitzki talk and answer questions on a Zoom call. There were many great questions, including, what was it like coming from Germany? Or what was it like winning an NBA championship? However, my favorite question was, how did you handle tough times while playing in the NBA? Dirk answered the question by highlighting, among other things, his shortcomings in the NBA playoffs and failing to reach the NBA finals. Dirk said that his failures were some of the toughest times. However, as he reflected, it was those failures that propelled him to greatness. Overall, he stressed it was both his good and bad memories that helped him achieve great things in his career. As graduating seniors, as we close out our high school careers, we often get caught up in what awaits us down the road. We are all excited and eager to move into the next phase of our lives, and with a brief walk through the senior pod or student center, you can hear people voice their readiness and enthusiasm, saying things like, I can't wait until college, or I'm so ready to leave. This enthusiasm is a great thing. All of us are prepared and capable of doing great things at our colleges and universities. However, we become so fixed on the future that we forget to take a look back on our journey to this point. The late musician Bob Marley states, in this bright future, you can't forget your past. As graduating seniors, it is our past experiences, both good and bad, that have prepared us for this moment and ultimately shaped us into the people we are today. We can't forget our past. Class of 2020, as we embark on new beginnings, let us not forget the road we traveled to get where we are today. Remember the mistakes you made along the way. Remember when you thought you could power through 5 major assessments all in one day your sophomore year. Or remember staring at your first AP calculus grade and realizing this class is no joke. I may or may not be speaking from personal experience. The point is, we all make mistakes and fall short of our goals. And it's important to remember these mistakes, not to bring up bad memories, but to reinforce the lessons you learned from them. Next, remember what it took to get here. Remember the extra hours studying for a test, or waking up early for a morning lift, or shooting the same scene over and over and over again until you get it just the way you like it. Over these past 4 years, all of us have worked toward being on this field, gazing upon our loved ones with us and those watching online today. This illustrious ceremony is a recognition of all the hard work and dedication each of us have put into our studies and respected crafts at Green Hill School. Take pride in that. Cherish the fact that your exceptional efforts in the classroom, on the playing field, or studio have propelled you to success and will continue to do so in the years to come. Finally, and most importantly, remember the moments that brought you joy. I think I can speak for the entire class when I say, Green Hill has provided us with countless memories that will last a lifetime. Whether it's performing in the annual kindergarten nutcracker, stampeding into the gym during the homecoming pep rally, or small moments we often take for granted, like as Josh mentioned, eating lunch in the dining hall with our friends. Green Hill has provided us with moments we will carry with us for a long time. It's these joyous moments that we will happily share with our friends and family. It's these moments that define our years as a high school student. As I was sitting in my room, passing the time by binge-watching shows on Netflix, I began to think of ways I could effectively conclude this speech. Frankly, the last thing I want to do is leave this audience with a generic, cheap, and cliche conclusion. Green Hill deserves better than that. The class of 2020 deserves better than that. So, after much reflection, I think I finally understand what Dirk was trying to tell us. It's the lessons we learn from our mistakes, the timeless values we've gained, and the countless memories created that not only help us achieve our goals, but ultimately help us bring about change and become productive members of society. Just as Dirk credited his past experiences for his great success, we too can use the tools Green Hill has provided us to advance our society and leave our mark on the world. Class of 2020, it is our turn to make our voices heard. It is our turn to generate positive change. It is our turn to lead in this bright future. But to do that, we must never forget our past. Thank you.
Thank you, Drake. Thank you, Josh. Members of the class of 2020, this has been a long time coming. I'm sure you are past ready to graduate. I'll tell you a little secret. You already did. Unless you're in trouble and you know who you are, your degree is conferred at the end of the trimester. But this ceremony is still so important. It's important to provide much-needed closure for a very strange and challenging year. And it's important for your parents to see you walk across this stage. Certain parts of your senior year are important as symbols, and this is one of them. It's symbolic of your hard work and your grit and determination, and it's also a rite of passage, though you really aren't leaving Green Hill, but changing status, moving from students to alumni, and joining a 70-year legacy. I hate to tell you this, you can never really leave Green Hill. And no, that's not supposed to sound like a threat. One thing this wild year reinforced in me is that nothing is for certain. Around the country, many people talked a lot about how this year's graduates had been cheated. And I understand that reaction. This is not the way any of us wanted your time as a Green Hill student to end. We should be in the Meyerson, in the air conditioning, surrounded by your extended family. But I reject the notion that you were cheated. It implies that you were owed something, and none of us is owed anything. That, in its essence, is my charge to you. Don't feel cheated. Instead, feel challenged. Each of you has been given so much by your teachers, your advisors, your coaches, your faith leaders, your tutors and counselors and learning specialists, by our stage staff and facilities crew and day porters, by your parents and grandparents. Many people played a hand in getting you to this point. I know you worked hard. No one gets through Green Hill without working hard. But you're probably not thinking about those people right now. What you're thinking is, I did it. And you did do it. Congratulations. You've worked hard, and you're ready for what's next. But don't forget those who helped you get to this moment. And this, your graduation from Green Hill, is the end of one moment. One moment in a series of many moments to come in your life where hard work will be required, where things won't turn out as expected, where you'll be asked to rise to the occasion whether you feel ready or not. It's called being an adult. And you will do it. I've seen you do it over and over again. You're smart, you're creative, you're talented, and you're hardworking. But most important, you're resilient and you're brave. Retain that resiliency, develop it, sharpen it, hone it, and stay brave. The world desperately needs brave people. Class of 2020, this isn't the ending you planned for, and it isn't the ending we wanted for you, but it doesn't matter. You're bigger than what this moment handed you. Don't feel cheated, feel challenged. Class of 2020, you're amazing, and you've been so much fun. Everyone here loves you so much. Good luck, and come see us. Congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, please rise for the playing of Hail to Green Hill.
Please be seated. I want to close today with a quote from civil rights icon and social justice warrior Representative John Lewis. You are a light. You are the light. Never let anyone, any person or any force, dampen, dim, or diminish your light. Study the path of others to make your way easier and more abundant. Graduates, class of 2020, may you always be the light and help to make the path for all more abundant. And now, I will dismiss you by advisories. Please exit from the same side of the field from which you entered and head straight back to your vehicles, please. First, the Bach and Cotton advisories in the back. Thank you all.